Welcome back to vlog number 3. Today we are going to be doing a leg day. Leg day is a bit challenging for me just because it's also not my strongest shit, but I'm trying to improve.
Skinny bitch.
I'm gonna take you along on the journey today, show you everything I'm doing. I might not explain all of it because I feel like legs are quite self-explanatory. You just train them as hard as you can. But I'm excited for it. It's my first leg day YouTube video. So I hope you guys like it. Please comment and subscribe with that as well. And let's do this. With legs, I've recently switched to Smith machine squats just because I really have a icky lower back. So by doing this, I can stabilize it a bit more. I can't go as heavy on squats, not that I'm a big squatter in terms of weight, but you know, I really feel like I can control the movement and put a lot of tension on my legs when doing Smith machine squats. I use the Sissy Boy pad. Not because I'm a sissy.
Are you sure about that?
I'm a bodybuilder. I'm not here to prove to anybody how tough I am. So I want to grow my legs, not hurt my neck. So use the Sissy Boy pad. It's there to help you. It's not going to take away your masculinity. So use it. The machine is a bit broken, if you can zoom in over there. So I think rather than continuing, I'm going to stop there because as I was going, the clip kept coming back. But I'm going to put away my weights now. For you guys that exercise and don't put away your weights, your membership should be revoked. We're here to help each other out. I do not want to get to a squat rack and there's 100 kilos on each side. So if you pack your weight, re-rack them when you're done. It's so simple. And then whoever wants to use the equipment can just use it without any hassle. The next exercise. So my leg day is structured as a quad and hammy focus day, both of them. So the next one we're going to be doing is standing straight leg deadlifts, which are probably one of my favorite exercises to do just because I like having strong hammies. So with this we're going to be doing 5 sets, I believe, of 12 to 15 reps. But my last 2 sets are going to be my top working sets, and then I'm just going to go until failure, and I'll show you guys what those look like. In doing these, try and keep your knees just a bend a little bit. Push your hips towards the back of the room. Imagine there's a chair all the way back there, and just pushing your hips all the way back, trying to reach the chair. And you should feel a nice squeeze in your hammies and in the bottom of your glutes. Is it even a man's bar? Yeah. The handle for sure then. That's what she said. Another thing that I found is frowned upon in the gym is straps. Like, if you use straps, it's fake. No, it's not. Once again, I'm training my hamstrings, not my forearms. I want to be able to put as much strain on my hamstrings as possible. So why would I want to kill myself trying to hold the bar when all the weight's supposed to be on my hamstrings? So get yourself a pair of straps, get yourself a belt. I'm not going to use a belt now, but it's things that are there to, that are meant to help you. So this is going to be my first working set. I don't really have a amount of reps I'm aiming for. I'm just trying to go as hard as possible and see how many I can do. Because I'm not the strongest, I really try and focus on how much intensity I put in, not the weight, because strength is proportional. So I think it's not about how much weight you can move, it's about how much work you do with that weight. So if you can make the weight work for you, I can have only a 5 kilogram on you and I would still probably get a good hammy pump. Yeah, I'm very tired. So don't worry about your strength. I'm guilty of that. I'm very insecure about how strong I am. What I've come to realize is I might not be the strongest, but that doesn't mean I'm not working the hardest. As long as you're working hard, irrelevant of the weight, you'll make gains and you'll make progress. And just by partially adding to that each weight, you're gonna make more progress, and eventually you'll still not feel strong, but you'll be stronger than most people out there. So don't worry, especially if you're somebody new in the gym. I'm no professional. I've only been doing this for a couple of years, but I just want to help you. And I know I struggle a lot with not being as strong as everybody else, but I can promise you I work a lot harder than those guys that are strong. So just work hard and your strength will get there. I failed my form a bit there, but overall, a good 4 sets. It was only 4, not 5. I was mistaken. So next up, we're going to be doing leg press. So I'm just going to pack away my weight, and I'll see you over there. This leg press is a bit wonky, so I cannot put a considerable amount of weight on. Just because the left side of the bench tilts inward, so I can't go max out fully, but I can still do full range of motion. As I said, it's not about the weight, it's about the weight does for you. Well, that was very tough. The next exercise is going to be 3 sets of leg extensions. Some good news and bad news. The MPC have updated their weight cap limits. So I think it's by 2 to 4 pounds, which is roughly about almost 2 kilos. So that's a good thing and a bad thing. The good thing is that smaller guys like me that are shorter, whatever, will have a better chance against taller guys that fall in the class D range if I were ever to go to overalls. The challenging part it makes for me is if I stay natural, I've got that extra weight to try and compete with, and I'm already quite a few, like 20 pounds, roughly 10 to 8 kilos below the competing guys. So it's like a blade with two swords.
What? What the?
But we carry on training. And by the way, just a topic on steroid use. If you do not have a clear, definitive goal why you are using them and why you are putting potential risks to life, then don't do it. I'm still contemplating, and I have been contemplating this, and it's not an easy decision. So to those guys who take this decision lightly, I don't feel like that's reason enough. You really need to have good reasoning why you want to do it. Like, I've realized I would want cramp. I would love to become a pro in the near future, maybe in the next 3 or 4 years, if God bless me like that. But do not just use it because you want to look cool and be bigger than your friends. That's no, what's the purpose of that? You have a definitive goal and work towards that goal with supplementing it with something like steroids. Steroids is not the main game and everything. So just be wise about your decisions. Consult with your friends and family before you do anything irrational. The reason I'm slowing so much down on this leg extension, it's not a really heavy stack. It's just so I put on a 5 kilo as well. So I'm really slowing the eccentric and the eccentric, whatever it's called. Slowing it down. Once again, tension, muscle under tension. And that's the way I'm going to maximize my workout the most. The final exercise we're going to be doing is standing calf raises on the Smith machine. And I know there are some of you guys that skip calves, never mind on leg day, but every day. So I'm not saying I have the biggest calves. Let's get it.
Psych!
I really do try and train them at least once or twice a week. And so this is a great movement because you can load the bar quite heavily. So that was the workout for today. I really hope you guys enjoyed this type of content. I enjoy making it. It's a bit different. I think it's still going to take me a few more videos to get the total hang of it. But please do let me know down in the comments what other type of content you would see, what I can improve on, etc, etc. But now I'm going to look at my pump, my leg pump. I'm pretty sure there's not going to be a whole lot of lines, but it's not looking too bad. I'm going to finish off the video there. Thank you guys for watching. I really do appreciate the support. Please like and leave a comment. I've already said that twice, but it really helped me a lot to progress this channel, make more quality content. So have a good day, and thanks for watching. See you in the next one.